Hello, hello, and welcome to this week's Superwomen Wellness Connection channel. My name is Kim Goltom, and I'm a certified master wellness coach and the founder of the Empowered Living for Superwomen program. I'm excited to have a very special guest with us here today. Her name is Sandra Johnson. Sandra, welcome.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. I'm so excited. And the superwomen out there, you are in for a treat today. Sandra Johnson is the president and founder of the Mentoring Youth into Healthy New Dimensions Spiritually program. And I'm just so excited to learn more about this nonprofit organization that she's created and everything about it. So I'd love to learn more about this organization. And if you could please share with everybody how this even came to fruition at all.
Woo. This actually, the thought came about probably a few years ago. With nonprofits, it's interesting because you have this idea, you want to help people, you want to do this. And then as soon as you come up with the idea, then all these other things start coming out, right? So it's like, oh yeah, so if I focus on this, then I could do this too. And I remember initially probably about 4 or 5 years ago, I would run with my BGR sister. So BGR is Black Girls Run. And every time I'd run, like 5 o'clock in the morning, I'd come home and I'd tell my husband, I need to start a nonprofit because, you know, we're not doing anything for the young girls. We're not doing anything for the young girls. You know, it's all of us. You know, we're some older women out there and we're not doing anything for the youth. And every time I'd come back again, say the same thing. And he used to say, well, okay, well, we'll start your nonprofit. I'm like, oh, okay. You know, and then 6 months later, I come back again with this other epiphany and, you know, I wanted to do this, wanted to do that. And I actually decided based on some things that were happening in my life with my family, just around me, very close, that said, Sandra, it's time. This is your purpose. And so what happened was, I sent an email to my pastor and I said, Pastor, I said, you know, a lot of things been on my mind, a lot of things that has been happening around me from my past, from Kurt, certainly my present, that just keeps bringing me back to this place. And that place was being able to mentor young women who look like me. Who have had experiences similar to what I've had in the past, what was happening to some of the young women in my family. And I needed to pull that all together. And I remember his email back to me saying, so Joe, it's time. And so, and I'm paraphrasing exactly what he said, because my pastor is very, very like, you know, this based on this, 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 and this, this is your time. This is your season, I believe, is probably what he said. And so about maybe a year prior to me filing all the paperwork that I needed to do, because I didn't realize the process of starting a nonprofit was a whole lot of work, right? Yeah. And what other people don't realize, it's a whole lot of money. And so started off initially filing paperwork. And then I remember I went to a mentoring program in the state of Virginia. And I remember sitting there with a group of people who were starting their nonprofits, and everyone sort of the same thing. Didn't really have, they knew what they wanted to do, but just couldn't put it all together. And I remember the trainer saying, find one thing, focus on that, and grow from there. And so the nonprofit initially started off as a mentorship for young ladies who were victims of molestation, victims of sexual assault, domestic violence, and that's how we started. And so started off with Kenya Speaks, which is one of the programs under MINDS, and that is certainly a mentor program that provided a safe space. And safe space meaning that it was an opportunity for young ladies who had similar experiences to engage with each other in a non-judgmental environment. And that was important to me because being, and I'll just be transparent, because one of the things that I'm just a firm believer in is that we have to be transparent in our experiences. And how do you help other people heal from their experiences if you're not going to be transparent? And so, you know, safe space, non-judgmental, where people can share their stories, share their hurt, but then in that process, learn how to heal from those experiences. So that's how we started. And then out of that grew DIP, which is another one of our programs, which is Daughters of Incarcerated Parents. Another transparency moment for me, because I'm okay with that, is my daughter's father had spent some time in prison. My daughter, who I think you may have heard me talk about Aja over and over and over, and she just, in my mind, just the best little girl ever. And I've given her all these great experiences, right, in her life. She's been cheering since she was four. She's graduated a year ahead of time. She's now a junior at ODU. She's rode horses. She's done all these things. So I'm like, okay, why would you feel like you had some issues because your dad was in jail for some time? Well, I just felt like I just couldn't have a conversation with anybody who's had the experiences that I had. So I'm like, okay, there's something missing there. And so she wanted to start a platform, a program, Daughters of Incarcerated Parents. And when I tell you that she started reaching out to some young ladies at ODU, we ended up with 9 young ladies with similar experiences who wanted to mentor through our program. And I was amazed. And so what said to me, there was a need. So certainly when you have a nonprofit, if a need is there, that's when you have to really start saying, okay, we gotta tighten this up because the need's there. And now this is, for me, confirmation that what we're doing is walking in our purpose. And that's how we got started. That's how we got started.
Well, sounds like there's so many different layers, and this is really exciting. What kinds of things do you have happening for Q4?
Wow, interesting. Q4 is already here, right? So Q2 you know? Went by, Q3 went by thanks to COVID, and now we're in Q4. One of our biggest things that we just continue to focus on, that we continue to be a resource for our mentees, are our treasure boxes. So one of the things that we are just adamant about is trauma to treasure. And how do we give people tools to be able to help them to heal from their traumatic experiences? So we actually have treasure boxes that I think are pretty cool.
Yeah, those are great. It says
trauma to treasure, DIP, which is our Daughters of Incarcerated Parents, Kenya Speaks, and then of course a little bit about our program. But in here, which is pretty neat, is that we provide different resources for our mentees. Everything from a stress ball to one of our biggest things is journaling, and we do provide them with a journal book that actually goes inside. And actually, I have this in front of me. So journaling, I met a young lady from actually my hometown, which was weird because I was looking for journal books. And one of the things that we always talk about is how do we teach people how to journal their experiences? Because we know part of healing is journaling and being able to get out of your head somewhere, whether it's with somebody, but sometimes writing on paper is just, I mean, incredible. And so I met this young lady, her name is Terry Martinez. She created this book called Journaling for Self-Care. And when I tell you, and it's for young adults, which is mainly the young ladies that we mentor. And so that's one of the other things that goes inside the treasure boxes. Stress balls, chewing gum. I think it's funny learning that chewing gum is a thing to help relieve stress. Walgreens down the street from my house actually donated all of these different like hand creams and facial washes. But those are things that we put in the treasure boxes, things that help with the healing process. And so we give them to our mentees.
That's fantastic.
Yep.
Wow. So if somebody wanted to either add, different items to the box or even, I don't know if this is something you do, but do people have an opportunity to sponsor boxes if that's something that they wanted to do? Okay, great.
They can.
Does that work?
Yeah. So they can. And actually we can always add logos on. I'm a firm believer that when someone gives you things, you acknowledge them, you make it visible to other people. So we can certainly add their logos into the boxes. Certainly whatever we do ask that whatever they donate, that it's something that helps in the healing process for somebody that has had a traumatic experience. So it could be health related, it could be an item, like I said, distress ball type things, those kind of things, but anything that helps or aids in the healing process, but certainly, yes.
That's incredible. Wow. So many layers, and talk about empowerment in so many different ways. That's exciting. So I can't wait to hear the wellness tips that you're going to be sharing with everyone today, because there's so many different places that you could pull from. What's wellness tip number one?
Woo! Wellness tip number one. It's interesting because I keep thinking, you know, to ask me to talk about wellness, because then there's me who I've had, you know, I've done the whole, oh, I think I need to do some cleansing. Oh, I think I need to change my eating. All those things.
Yeah.
All those things from a physical and a spiritual standpoint to me come together. And so the three things for me that come to mind, and I just have to laugh because one of my best friends, her name is Vaughn, gave me a rock about 5 years ago. I don't even know what it was for. Maybe it was for a holiday. But on that rock, it said balance. And at that time, you know, I was doing a couple of different things. You know, I've always been very active in my church and just love everything that I do for church. And then, of course, work, right?
Yeah.
But then now you add all these different layers of nonprofits, and you know, kids are going off to college now. And I thought, okay, kids off to college, but that means, okay, I get to have all this free time to myself. And then I continue to coach Girls on the Run, and then all these yarn, all these things. And I said, the biggest part to self-care is balance for me. And how do you balance all these things out? And so for me, the three of those things kind of go together, because after that became discipline. So, you know, you have the balance, and you know you need to balance out your day. You know, very familiar with Jan Howroyd, one of her biggest quotes is discipline is not a dirty word. I think you may have trained me on that a few times anyway. And so with that discipline, balance just kind of flows. And so for me, just having a structured day, I know when I am in my kind of workout mode and in my running mode, I do that early in the morning just to kick and jumpstart my day, whatever those physical activities that, you know, that someone does, whatever your routine is, but that discipline helps to keep your balance. And I realize that more and more and more as I do more things. And then it doesn't seem like I'm structured to where, oh my God, it's 5 o'clock. If I don't shift here in 10 minutes, I'm going to do this. The discipline becomes your balance, becomes routine for you. And so to me, that was just a big deal. And then I thought about it. So it's like, what about those moments where it just doesn't balance out, right?
Yeah.
Resetting. Resetting is the third and kind of, for me, the last thing. I had to really tell myself that it's okay to reset. Because sometimes when you don't have that balance and things are just kind of like just coming at you and all the discipline and that structured plan day. Remember, Kim, I think you taught me how to plan my day out with some block time and discipline. And all of a sudden, something comes and it's like, ooh, that wasn't on schedule. That wasn't on the plan. And I have about 10 more minutes over here that I need to, right?
Yeah.
Resetting. Yeah. And it is okay, and telling yourself that it is okay to reset in your day, in your life, in whatever's going on. So for me, those things, balance, discipline, and resetting are just important. So
I love that. Yeah. And that's something that everyone needs to hear, whether it's new information or reminders, right? Mm-hmm. You know, how does a superwoman, entrepreneur, you know, businesswoman, professional, mother, daughter, right?
Grandmother,
other labels.
Because life has changed for us. We talked about being the empty nesters, and so my husband and I went from, okay, we have three, our last three girls are in college, you know, it's about us, And then COVID happened. One of our oldest daughters is a trauma nurse. She works at night. She lives around the corner. And guess who has the grandkids a couple days out of the week, right? So now part of the structure in the day became, okay, almost five-year-old, you have school from 8:30 to 11:30 while Mimi is on a call and in a meeting, you know, and then the seventh grader. So now, you know, and you still have to learn how to balance it all out. So, you know, it's interesting. It's interesting, but yeah.
That's nice. And I know it is Domestic Violence Awareness Month.
Yes, it is.
And I was wondering if there's anything you'd like to share regarding Domestic Violence Awareness Month that might coincide, you know, with your organization.
Yep. I certainly, if I can stress it enough, if an opportunity presents itself to be able to support a shelter, a lot of times in this situation, I get emotional kind of thinking about it, particularly in a situation that we are in now, you find that a lot of women, a lot of young people are in environments where their abusers are more in the home than what they used to in the past. They don't have access a lot of times to getting out of their homes, even like they used to pre-COVID. And so if there's anything that I can stress and I can share, it's Domestic Violence Awareness Month. Keep sexual assault in mind, keep molestation in mind, keep all those things in mind, and the fact that people are, I shouldn't say people, but yeah, because it could be male, it could be female, you know, are in the homes with their abusers more than what they used to. So that's what I would share. If opportunity presents itself, please, you know, volunteer time, goods. Sometimes with the shelters, the need is there for home goods, for financial, of course, that's always right with nonprofits, because when you're trying to serve, you know, a huge population, people don't realize the cost. And you're trying to help people get on their feet or help people stay safe. So that's what I would say. Domestic Violence Month, year, it doesn't change at all. Yeah. Just this month is just, you know, just keep pushing the awareness.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And if someone is, you know, interested in learning more about your organization, participating in one aspect or another, how would they go about finding you on social media?
Awesome. So, yeah. So we have a Facebook page. So it's Mentoring Youth into Healthy New Dimensions is our Facebook page. We have a website. It's www.myihndscommunity.com. And on there, you can complete a form that says you're interested in learning more about our program, volunteering for our program, certainly looking for mentors that want to commit. And I'll just put that out there, is that when we look for mentors, we're looking for people to commit to a school year at least, because a lot of the ladies that, and I say ladies because that's the bulk of really who we work with. I haven't had any male interest and I wouldn't turn a male away, but they're so used to an environment where people are in and out of their lives that for us to create that consistency and for the relationship to develop, you know, the whole goal for a mentor-mentee relationship is that that relationship develops. And if you can't do that in a couple weeks or a couple months. So we ask that if someone does want to consider, that they consider, do I, one, have the time to be able to commit at least for a year, because we do ask that at least twice a month, even more if possible, that you engage with your mentee. And we realize that some people just don't have that type of, they want to, but they don't have that type of commitment.
Sure, sure. No, that's fantastic. Absolutely. Great. Well, thank you so much for being here and sharing more about your nonprofit and everything that you're doing for the local community. And actually, that's one thing I should ask before I let you go. Mm-hmm. You know, what is the, you know, as far as the geographic region that your organization covers, especially now that we are in a virtual world, I didn't know what that looks like.
Right. So that has opened up, fortunately and unfortunately, it's opened up our region. At one point, because we are Suffolk licensed for the state, we kind of thought that Suffolk school districts and closed school districts would be in our immediate reach. But now we realize that because of virtual, it's opened us up in almost, I shouldn't say almost, opened us up anywhere. So, yeah. The goal, though, is that hopefully when COVID is over, that we can have more face-to-face. So I don't want to, you know, hey, yeah, you're over in Alaska and, right. you know, your mentor is here, because the opportunity to have that physical in-person wouldn't be there. So we don't want to do it as much. But yeah.
That's nice. Okay. Well, that's good. And that's great for people when they're checking out your website and they're looking at you on social media, trying to learn a little bit more to kind of gauge, you know, where they may or may not fit into the program. Mm-hmm. So that's great. Yep. Well, thank you again. I appreciate everything.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, you're so very welcome. It's been wonderful to reconnect and see you.
Yes.
And
yes.
Until next time. Thank you so much.
Yes, again. Ma'am. All right.
With us here today and sharing all this wisdom.
Thank you for everything that you're doing as well. Certainly, I watch and follow you, and it's so interesting to see some of the things that you cook, or, you know, I don't know about that, Kim, but just learning, you know, it's great. So I'm excited.
Excellent. Well, thanks again. Well, have a great night. Take care.
Thanks, Kim. You too. Bye-bye.